Alright, in today's video, I wanted to take a second to talk to you about the new documentary on Netflix about Queen and Adam Lambert. So, going back in history a little bit, I was growing up quite a big fan of Queen, and I thought the style was really diverse, you know, blending hard rock with theatrical stuff, and almost disco and funk. Very, very eclectic, and it always really captured my ear as a music fan and a listener. And then, of course, Freddie Mercury died, very unfortunately, and far too young, and everybody thought this was the end of Queen. Now, in the years after that, I didn't lose interest, but I lost interest. I mean, we had the classic albums, and you know, they're always on rotation, they come on every now and again. Everybody loves to blast a bit of Queen from time to time. And I didn't really pay too much attention to the Queen going on tour with different singers and, you know, whatever. And truthfully, I just saw it as a bit of a, you know, Brian and Roger being a little bit like, well, we've ran out of money. You know, I mean, look at Fleetwood Mac, for instance. They've been on a farewell tour for the past 30 years. I mean, come on, give it a rest. Just saying. Anyway, a friend of mine convinced me heartily to watch this documentary about Queen and Adam Lambert. And I was like, yep, I'll get round to it. And it's been on my get round to it list for a while. Anyway, the other day I find myself at a loss of what to do in an afternoon. And I thought, Queen and Adam Lambert. Alright, so I popped it on, sat working away, just watching in the background, and then all of a sudden it gripped me and I was like, oh, this is really interesting. So I sat and I watched the full thing, and that's what today's video is about. I wanted to A, give you my review on it, and B, recommend it. So, having watched this documentary, I must say that I am a complete convert. Now, I won't go into too much detail for those of you that haven't seen it already, but let's just say Queen found Adam Lambert. As some of you may know, he was a runner-up on America's Got Talent or The X Factor, whatever it was. I think it was America's Got Talent. Now, the first thing that really caught my ear, and then subsequently caught my eye, was Adam Lambert's performance on America's Got Talent of Whole Lot of Love. I nearly said Whole Lot of Rosie then. Whole Lot of Love. You need cooling, baby, I'm not fooling. I'm gonna send you back to schooling. Way down inside, honey, you need it. That was... it was electrifying. It was breathtaking. It was the best performance of that song I've ever seen. Cover or otherwise. It was absolutely astonishing. Now, I don't know what sort of range Adam Lambert's got in his voice, but what I can tell you is, it's a lot. I mean, this guy can hit, like, high highs, and his voice is totally clean. He doesn't warble, he doesn't crackle, he's not struggling. I mean, this guy takes it in his stride. He has got some serious, serious pipes on him, and I was astonished watching that. I was like, wow, this guy really can sing. And long story short, Queen were invited to come and perform We Are The Champions for the final, and that's where they first saw of him. Now, skipping over some of the other details so that you can enjoy it in your own time, but essentially, Adam Lambert now essentially is a permanent member of Queen. Although they tour as Queen and Adam Lambert, I would imagine to respect the memory of Freddie Mercury. We can all agree, I'm sure, that for someone to step into the shoes of Freddie Mercury is a nigh on impossible task. I mean, in my eyes, Freddie Mercury is one of, if not the greatest rock star that ever lived. His voice was second to none, absolutely fantastic. His range was ridiculous, his ability to sing in different styles was ridiculous, just such a fantastic talent. The thing that converted me to being an Adam Lambert and Queen fan is the fact that he didn't try to emulate Freddie Mercury. But he kind of did, but he didn't. So Adam Lambert is Adam Lambert. Now, obviously, he is a gay man, and part of him being a gay man is, and I don't mean to generalise, but he's pretty flamboyant, as some gay men are, but he totally takes this in his stride. Like, it is part of who he is, and he's unashamedly flamboyant. He's unreservedly flamboyant. The guy does not give a fuck. He will come out wearing snakeskin, glitter, all the best bits of the 80s. He just doesn't give a shit, right? So, and I love that about him. He is who he is. But almost in homage to Freddie Mercury, he was who he was also, and he also had balls of steel. I mean, when Freddie Mercury was at the peak of his fame, only a few years previous, it was illegal to be homosexual. So, I mean, he had it rough. And I think, like it kind of says in the documentary, to mirror that, Freddie paved the way for people like Adam Lambert to be who they are. And I think that's a fantastic thing. I think people of all walks of life, creeds, colours, whatever, should be celebrated for their talents and for their eccentricities, because that's what makes life interesting. So Adam Lambert comes onto the stage, he's wearing the big coats and the David Bowie-esque jackets and, you know, completely not giving any fucks. And then he belts out Freddie's most challenging songs effortlessly. I mean, this guy can really, really sing. And yet, whilst doing it, he kind of puts a modern twist on it as well. He sounds like a modern singer. I'm not really sure how to musically describe that, but he sounds like a modern singer. He phrases words in quite a modern way, shall we say. And it completely works. Like, in the context of the band, it totally works. But more than that, he's taken the role and made it his own. And he's put his own spin on it, his own thing. Colour Me Converted, I think he's awesome. Massive fan. And watching the documentary, there's a level of sincerity that comes across about him. I mean, he's genuinely astonished himself that Queen asked him to sing with them. And then it became a tour, and it became a world tour, and it became multiple world tours. Man, he's just like a guy, just like everyone else. I mean, he comes across like this huge rock star when you see him on stage. But he's just a guy with insecurities and fragilities and, you know, like any of us. And it's really heartwarming to watch. It's quite endearing. And I came away from the documentary being like, fuck yeah, go you, Adam. Get in there, son. So anyway, I believe the documentary is called We Will Rock You, but check it out. It's on Netflix at the moment. God knows how long it's going to stay up there in cancel culture. But check it out while you can. It's absolutely awesome. I think it's about 2 hours long. I enjoyed every second of it, start to finish. There's some really great footage of Freddie as well, which is quite amusing. I didn't realise how brutal Roger Taylor is, can I just say. Guy's an absolute savage, but I found him hilarious and endearing at the same time. Go and watch it whilst it's still on. I command you. You'll enjoy it, I promise. Drop me a comment down below. Let's discuss it. Tell me what you thought of it. Tell me what you think of Queen carrying on with a different vocalist. Do you think it's a good move? Do you think it's a bad move? I was on the fence, pretty converted. Let's have a discussion about it. If it's your first time watching the channel, welcome. Thank you for watching. There's a myriad of content, mixing tutorials, all sorts of stuff. And in the coming weeks, months, whatever, I'm going to be expanding the channel a little bit and trying to do some different things, because I realise that I'm quite drum centric. I focus a lot on drums, and not that I'm getting bored of it, but there's a whole world of stuff out there that I want to discuss with you and teach you and talk to you so cool. Subscribe, hit the bell, all that bullshit. See you in the next video.